The Spirit of God says, time is up for those who are corrupt. Hello friends, it's another amazing day in the Lord Jesus. I wanted to bring up Mark Taylor's prophecy from 2015. I love this prophecy. I posted this on my Telegram channel last week and I felt a compulsion to share it on YouTube as well. This is the prophecy released through Mark Taylor in 2015. Time is up for those who are corrupt. The Spirit of God says, time is up for those who are corrupt. For I shall begin to remove those who stand for evil in leadership and stand in the way of my agenda. Judges, senators, congressmen, and women of all kinds, even in the local, state, and federal lines, even the Supreme Court is not immune from their corrupt and evil ways. For I will remove some and expose their backdoor deals which have been at play. For my America has been chosen as a launching platform for my harvest, and she will be a light onto the world once again as I clean up that which is the darkest. Fear not, America, your greatest days are ahead of you. Arise, my army, and fight, and watch what I will do for you. This word was released in 2015 and it remains true today. It may have taken longer than anyone expected, but that word released by the Spirit of God through a true prophet, Mark Taylor, he is a true prophet, it will come to fruition. Now we know from Amos 3:7 that the Lord does not do anything without first telling his prophets. The entire body of Christ, we can all flow in the prophetic, however, not everyone is a prophet. But when you do hear from a prophet, do not take that word that is released lightly or think that it has changed over the months and years. It has not changed. That word came from the Lord. It's solid. It is from the Spirit of God. It's breathed by the Holy Spirit, and it takes faith to believe until the end. When we stay in the Spirit, and do not fall into wiles and snares of the flesh that is doubt, despair, worry, or fear, then that word and every promise that the Lord gives us remains steadfast in our hearts. When you're staying in the Spirit, it's easy to believe the word of God. But when you fall into the flesh, into fear, worry, anxiety, despair, etc., then that's when doubt has its place. Remain in the Spirit, remain believing, stirring our faith always, and interceding, because we are called to be His ambassadors in this time. When we are resolute, that's how we draw in this harvest that is promised. All this had to happen. The shaking had to occur for the exposition of evil, for judgment on the nation, and also judgment on the body of Christ. The Lord tried and tested our hearts so that gold could come forth, but He was also preparing us for the new beginning that is ahead of us. His promises remain true because the Lord does not do anything without first telling His prophets. No one knows the twists and turns that are taken for this prophecy to come to fruition, but we know it will come to fruition. This is how we get to draw eyes to the Lord and bring a harvest for Him, because despite the storms of the world, those who are truly standing on the rock that is Yeshua will be in a state of peace, will believe the words of the prophets and will not point to them and call them false prophets. That is another snare of the enemy. Only the immature believer will point at a true prophet and call them false, because the prophecy did not play out in the manner which the world expected. The Lord will work any way that he deems. And delays occur when the body of Christ does not rise up. But the Lord is gracious and he's merciful. Even though it's taken some time, there's been a great transformation. The body of Christ truly is being very much so refined during this time. We will see this prophecy manifest in due time. And I, for one, am looking forward to it with all my heart, because I believe the Lord. When he gives me a promise and I got the confirmation around that promise, I hold on to it until the end. I've learned this through the years. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. I pray that the peace of the Lord surrounds you, the joy of the Lord fills you, and that you remain steadfast, unshakable during these times. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Shalom.